Students, here we shall discuss about root mean square value, that is RMS value. To understand about the root mean square value, we have to have some basic idea about science and engineering problems. Let us take for example the alternating current variations. The alternating current is transmitted from one place to another place by the vibration of electrons. The vibration of electrons is represented as a sine wave, and the upper vibrations are there and the downer vibrations are there, and both the vibrations are spreading the current in the same direction. Even though it is an alternating current, so the current flow is in the same direction, that is from the generating station to the consumer station. Now, if I is equal to Im sine theta, it is for an example, you need not confuse about this. Simply the upper and lower vibrations are spreading the current in a direction. I'll tell you another example. Let you imagine a silent pond and let you drop a stone at the middle of the pond, and when the stone strikes the surface of the pond, the energy possessed by the stone is transferred to the surface of the pond, and by which waves are created. The waves are carrying the energy from the center to the bank of the pond. And let you imagine the movement of the water molecules. The water molecules, they move up and down. They are not transferred from one place to another place, but the energy is transferred from one place to another place simply by the movement of the water particles up and down. The energy is transferred from the center of the pond to the bank of the pond. Similarly, the vibration of electrons can transmit electrical energy from here. We have shown that the vibration of electrons, so it is represented by a sine wave, and it is having an upper vibration and a lower vibration. And even though it is having an upper vibration and a lower vibration, the energy is transmitted as an average. That average we have to find out. If we find out a normal average as per the analytical geometry, the average by a variation is the area under the curve divided by the base. Now, if it is symmetrical, the waves are symmetrical about the positive x-axis and the negative x-axis, when you find out the average, it is becoming zero. So that we have to go for another representation. Let us square each and every coordinate, and the positive coordinates, that is f of x the whole square, the positive coordinates are represented from 0 to pi, and the negative coordinates also, when they are squared, it would become positive. From pi to 2 pi it has. The root mean square value is the area under the curve divided by the base. The area under the squared curve divided by the base. Now, let us take a smaller strip of dx of width. Width dx. So, the area is f of x the whole squared into dx. The area of the smaller strip is f of x the whole squared into dx. Therefore, the root mean square value can be taken as square root of a to b f of x the whole squared into dx divided by b minus a. Now b minus a, for your understanding, it has been given from a to b, the second curve. So the model is the same, but the root mean square value is defined by square root of integral a to b f of x the whole squared into dx divided by b minus a, from which we can understand that the area under the curve y bar squared is equal to integral of a to b f of x the whole squared into dx. Now let us take another example. It may be a spread of heat from the origin 0. So at the origin a heat source is there, heat is generated, it will be spread in the negative x direction and it will be spread in the positive x direction also. So the variation of heat from minus L to L is represented by f of x. If you want to find out the average heat from minus L to L, and the average value is area under the curve divided by the base, now let us generalize the things. Root mean square value is found out for a symmetrical variation of a periodic function. Root mean square value is equal to square root of integral of a to b f of x the whole squared into dx divided by the base, that is b minus a. And the mean square value is represented as y bar squared is equal to integral of a to b f of x the whole squared into dx. And generally the variation in science and engineering problem may be in sound, may be in electricity, or may be in heat propagation. So anything it may be, if the variation is symmetrical, so we cannot find out the average value. The average value is the area under the curve divided by the base. If the curve is symmetrical about the plus x axis and minus x axis, the area under the curve would be equal to zero. In that case, we will be going for squaring each and every coordinate, by which we will find out the squared wave, and the mean square value will be equal to the area under the curve divided by the base. If it is needed for the root mean square value, and we have to take out the square root of the mean square value. Now y bar squared is representing the squared value, that is area under the curve it is representing. If you want the mean square value, you have to divide this area under the curve by the base, and we will be having various limits. Now the limits are between, they may be number 1 minus L comma L, or it is minus pi comma pi. Number 2, they may be between 0 comma 2L, or it may be between 0 comma 2 pi, or it may be between number 3 0 comma L or 0 comma pi. So between these intervals, in core mathematics we are going to solve the problems. Now you are having a clear-cut understanding about the root mean square value and the squared value or the mean square value, etc., and the average, the difference between the average value and the root mean square value, and about the symmetrical functions or periodic functions.